Thanks. Tonight's gonna be super interesting. And I'm gonna ease into it. Or it's just gonna sporadically just shit out of my mouth. We'll see what happens. This next song is called Triple Scoop. It's off of a vinyl record we have over there if anyone's interested. If not, it's online and shit too. But if you like vinyl, got that. Yeah, woo! Cool. Yeah, this song I wrote with my best friend for our other best friend going through a really tough time. Some very serious mental health stuff, visited them in the hospital, and then we didn't really know what to do, so we wrote a song. And yeah, this song basically goes out to anyone who has someone in their life who you have been for, or been there for in a very important time, or in very important times you have had people there for you. Everyone needs people to support them and vice versa. And sometimes when we don't see how awesome we are, the people around us slowly but surely try and help us see otherwise. That's what the song's about.
Thank you.
Shout out to Dan Padley on the guitar tonight. And Eric Martin on the bass. And David Hurlin on the drums. This next song is a relatively new one. Also, could I get a touch more vocal on my monitor? And maybe a little less lead guitar up here. The song's called Headgear. It's about my mouth guard that I wear at night, which I haven't been wearing recently, which is not good. It's like grind my teeth. It sounds really creepy. Does anyone here grind their teeth in their sleep? It's like the worst feeling when someone wakes you up and is like, hey, like, you're really great and all, but did you know that you sound like a demon in your sleep? It's like, no shit. That's what this song's about. It's also the first song we've ever attempted to like send the labels and like all that stuff. And out of all my songs, I sent them the one about my mouth guard. So.
Thank you.
Awesome. Thank you so much. Could I get a little more vocal on my monitor, please? Thank you so much. This next song is called Time is a Shitty Friend. It's as if time were a person out to steal your significant other. If you were here thinking this was gonna be a sappy Valentine's Day show, you were wrong. Sorry about that.
Thank you.
so much for being here tonight and enduring the weather. Iowa is weird like that. Kind of throws us curveballs all but 5 days out of the year. This is not one of those 5 days, but thank you for being here. It means a lot. Also, it means a lot that we have had the opportunity to be playing with Katie Sinn all weekend. What a lovely person and just a musician and just entity in general. Katie Sinn's the fucking shit. So round of applause for Katie. Yeah, this weekend we've been testing out a very new song we're gonna throw at you tonight. Yeah, the song is about seeing an ex that you are trying to be friends with, and you're being super chill about it. And then they invite you to their party, and you're like, yeah, well, all right, I'll come to your party. And then you're at their party, at their house, and you're like, oh, never mind, I'm like totally not chill with this at all. That's what this song's about. Thank you. Thank you. This next song is called Planetarium. It's off of the record we have over there. Also, in case there wasn't any during that last song, if I could get some reverb out there, that'd be awesome. Just because this one's about being in space and shit, so I'd love it to be like super spacey and shit. The main line of this song, it's really fun to play shows where my grandparents aren't at, because I'm from Iowa, and my grandparents are the shit, and they come to a lot of my shows. But it always feels weird saying shit and talking about being high and stuff in front of them, so they're not here tonight, so I'm gonna swear as much as I possibly can, if that's all right. And the song is about being high at the Chicago Planetarium. I had a lot of revelations. I was comparing the stars to my life, and I was like, wow, I am with the stars, and the stars are with me, and mama, you know? One of those moments. It's a lot of fun. Anyways, this song is vaguely positive. It's about universes elsewhere, and every thought you have creates a different universe. So if you think positively, at least the shit you're thinking about is happening in a good way somewhere else. So, yeah.
In your head, won't let go of you in your small bed. The wall is cold, so I'm wrapped up in dark matter that we can't touch. 'Cause a million miles away,
Again, give it up for my bandmates. Oh my God, they're. I'm so lucky to get to play music, and I'm so lucky to get to play it with other people. It's so therapeutic. Seriously, I feel bananas, but I'd be way more bananas if I wasn't doing this with these pals. Okay, cool. Yeah, this next song is also off that record over there. Also, I recognize most people in this audience, and you already have it, so I'm just like annoying you about something that you were already nice enough to purchase. So sorry about that. But yeah, vinyl's super cool. One of my favorite Iowa bands, Hex Girls, is from this town, and they recently put out a record too. So there's so many things you can buy out there in the world. Go buy all of it. Cool. This song's called Red. Thanks for being here. Thank you. Thank you. We're gonna pretend like that was our last one, but because it's shitty outside, we're gonna just go straight into the other part of stuff. Unless you want us to stop now, then we'll stop. I'm just trying not to waste your time. I don't want to be wasting your time. Just wasted your time by doing that. Sorry about that. So this next song is a song that a really good friend of mine over in Ireland covered, and it reintroduced me to it. And so I started playing it with him, and it was a lot of fun. And now I've been just playing it on my own. I think most musicians start out covering songs before they start writing their own. It just kind of happens naturally. You get inspired and you do that, and then you just start doing your own shit, and then you try and do both, and you throw in a cover during a set, because it's a thing a lot of people do.
I was in the night.
Recorded this song last year around Valentine's Day, and it's still that weekend. So we'll do one along those lines. It's by one of my favorite songwriters for a lot of different reasons. And if you don't know of him, please look him up. There's a really good documentary about him. But Daniel Johnston is. Really, really awesome. The song's by him. Dan and I released this through Little Village, and it's out on Spotify and all that jazz. Thank you so much for being here and for the Octopus for hosting us. This is a really lovely space, and it always sounds really good, and I always feel very comfortable in here. And I don't always feel comfortable in spaces. One, just as a very anxious person, but also as a female. So shout out to this place for being somewhere I can just hang out. It's very nice. Cool. Cool. Yeah, thanks again. Thank you for my bandmates for driving through all this shitty weather all weekend. They're just really cool dudes. This is the hype of my month. So, you know, I'm just extra emotional today. So, I just want to cry, but I'm dehydrated, but I want to cry. So, maybe I will later. Who knows? Let's all cry later. I'm kidding, don't cry unless it's happy tears. Okay, sorry, song. Bye, thanks, cool.
Give up until
Thank you so much for being here. My name's Elizabeth Bowen. Please get home safe, tip your bartender, and tip them well. And yeah, we hope to be back here again soon. Cool. Thank you so much. Have a good night. Bye.